The Tao of Self-Confidence, Episode 395.
Welcome to The Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. Visit our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.
Well, hello, friend. Welcome to the Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. I'm your host today, Sheena Yap Chan, and today I have an amazing lady on the show today. She's an actress, a filmmaker, and a family physician, and I'm just really excited to have her on and share her story with us today. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce you to Yvette Lu. Yvette, how are you today? Maybe you can fill in a little bit more about yourself to our listeners.
Sure. Thank you for having me on, Sheena. It's great to be part of your show. So I'm a family doctor, as you mentioned, and I also act and I make content. So whether that be film, recently I've made a web series, and I have a special interest in content related to health. But I also enjoy all sorts of things like drama, comedy, etc.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And Yvette, what's your cultural background?
I am Chinese Canadian.
Thanks for sharing that. And what would be your favorite self-confidence quote?
This was a tough one when I was thinking about self-confidence, because I have a lot of self-confidence quotes that really inspire me. One of the ones that I've used for a long time is "start someplace, go somewhere." And the reason why I like that one is because sometimes people don't start things because they're afraid they don't know where they're going. And the way I like to think is that if you just start somewhere and have a general idea of what direction you're going, you can always change your direction if you find out that when you get more information, it's actually a different place that you want to head to. I always use the example of like an airplane. Say you're flying from here to Hawaii. When an airplane is flying, the pilot is normally making like very minute adjustments, east, west, north, south, etc., depending on the wind direction and all sorts of weather factors and other factors. But the pilot always stays on course because she or he knows that the destination is Hawaii or wherever the destination is. But if the pilot is really not sure where the destination is, then this person can easily get off track and then the plane will end up completely in the wrong place or in a place where the pilot originally did not want to go.
Thanks for sharing that quote. And I love that, right? Like what you mentioned, sometimes we're so afraid to start because we're so afraid of what could go wrong, not realizing if we just start and just keep going, like we'll get there eventually. And there's many different ways to get to that end result. As long as we just keep on going, we'll get there for sure. So thanks for sharing that. And in your own words, how would you define self-confidence?
That's a tricky one as well, because there are so many ways to define it. For me, I think I define it as courage, because to have confidence in yourself and to take that confidence and to accomplish things, it often requires a lot of courage.
Thanks for sharing that. I also believe courage is something that's really important in self-confidence, right? Because we all have fears. We're all scared of something. It's just overcoming that fear and just taking the action anyway, having the guts and the courage to do it really gives us that boost of confidence to keep going and keep on helping us take new, you know, obstacles and challenges along the way. So thanks for sharing that. And Yvette, what was your life like before your discovery of self-confidence?
Well, I think that it's difficult to find an exact moment where I had no self-confidence versus had self-confidence. It's sort of like an ongoing journey. I was really always very lucky because my parents were very loving and kind. So they always worked to instill self-confidence in me from a very young age. But of course, like there are lots of things that happen in school and in as you're growing up that can wear away at self-confidence. Some of the things I did when I was little, growing up, definitely helped with my confidence, like making sure that my parents would help me make sure that I prepared well so that I would be prepared for exams. I used to do a lot of piano recitals and things like that, and those definitely require a lot of courage, especially at a young age. But we do our best. My parents would help me do my best to be prepared for them. And that's one of the things that I've learned and that has been told to me in the past, is that one of the ways to have confidence is to be well prepared. And I think that's another very good confidence quote. The remedy or the prescription to confidence is preparation. So I can't pinpoint an exact moment where I had confidence and I didn't. I think it's really an ongoing journey towards confidence, because it's sort of something that goes up and down, right? Like sometimes when you're doing really well, you have more confidence, but especially as an actor, you're always going to auditions and you're always suffering from rejection and, you know, parts that you don't get, that can wear away at your confidence. So it's really important to stay focused on why you're doing what you're doing and what really inspires you so that you can continue to have the confidence to pursue your goals.
Thanks for sharing that. And, you know, what was that point in your life when you realized, like, you can be, you know, the person that you are today? Because, I mean, I'm sure, you know, people, when people ask you what you do and you're saying you're an actress, filmmaker, and a family physician, it's like, how do you do it? Like, you know, where do you, you know, what was that aha moment when you realized you wanted to do, you know, these things in your life, you know, like you got to choose what you wanted to be? What was like the aha moment when you had that boost of confidence?
I think the place where I am now is just sort of a culmination of all my past and all the decisions that I've made in my past. I really believe that the choices you make determine your future. So in the past, I've made a lot of choices that have brought me to where I am now. Like, I always liked science, and medicine was always a possibility for me beginning from very early on in high school. And so I went into science in undergrad. And during my undergrad, I discovered that I also liked acting. So at that point, I had to make a decision as to like whether I wanted to pursue acting or medicine. And at that time, I chose to pursue medicine. But I also chose to keep going in my acting during the time off that I had. So I was in med school, and I did during my first summer after med school, I did a Shakespeare play. And then the second summer after my second year of med school, I went to New York and studied acting with an excellent program at Circle in the Square in New York City for 8 weeks. So these are the choices that I've made over time. And I believe that if you know sort of what you want, or even if you don't know what you want, if you know what you're interested in and you make choices that are in alignment with your goals, then you can eventually have the life that you want, or at least some semblance of it.
Thanks for sharing that. And I like how you mentioned, you know, even though you chose medicine, you still had acting, you know, a part of your life. It didn't matter if it was for fun or, you know, as a career, you just had it. And along the way, it just, everything worked out because, like you mentioned, you were in alignment of the choices that you made. And because of that, what's your life been like now?
Well, it's an ongoing puzzle to figure out where my choices are going to lead me, because I do continue to practice medicine. I also do acting as well. And sometimes you don't have too much control over how your career as an actor will go. Whereas for medicine, as you know, in Canada, we always need more family doctors. So there's definitely a lot of job opportunities for me there. So basically, it's like a combination of being prepared for opportunities and putting myself facing in the direction that I want to go, so that when opportunities come along, I'll be prepared. For example, like for acting, I am continually in acting class, so that when the right job comes along, then I can book it and I'll have the skills to be able to achieve it in an accomplished manner. And one of the ways in which my acting and medical careers has come together really nicely recently is that I've been doing a lot of work with Breakfast Television, which is like a television show that is in different cities across Canada. And I speak once or twice a month about medical topics on Breakfast Television. And that's an excellent way in which my skills as a doctor and my skills as an actor have come together, because being an actor, I'm quite comfortable on camera. And having had that opportunity and said yes to that opportunity, that's led to another opportunity even more recently, which is the opportunity to be in this production that we just released right now. It's called Who Cares? And it's a web series about caregivers. And what we do is, as a family physician, I interview caregivers and we sort of find out about what their challenges are. And then I go and find some experts and we interview the experts. And then we go back and explain the experts' solutions to the caregivers. And this is a documentary web series, and we've produced one episode, and we're actually seeking funding for the next 5 episodes right now. And actually, we're doing a competition. We're part of a competition with TELUS, and we're asking people to give us votes and shares so that we can be one of the teams that are funded for making more episodes. But that's a really wonderful way in which my acting and my medicine have come together. And I think it's been happening because I've sort of set my direction and I have said yes to opportunities and I've continued to train so that when the opportunities come, that I have the skills.
Thanks for sharing that. And I love how you didn't sacrifice one. You know, you just made it work no matter what. I mean, you know, having, you know, talking on like a TV show like Breakfast Television, which I also watch too because I'm from Toronto, you get to talk about medicine and be in the camera at the same time. It's like, you know, why would you settle for one when you can do both at the same time, which is great. And, you know, you just had, you know, great examples of doing that. So thanks for sharing that. And, you know, to the woman who's listening to your episode, she may be in her own journey of self-confidence. What would be that one tip you would give to her?
What she should do is really figure out what she wants. And if she doesn't know exactly what she wants, she should just sort of figure out some ideas about what she could possibly want. Because you don't have to know exactly what you want, as I said before, but you should sort of start heading in a direction. And as you go along, you can refine that direction to what is more in alignment with your values, because sometimes you don't actually know what you want. Like when I went into medical school, I thought to myself, oh, well, after medical school and residency, I'm going to for sure want to go into like a 3-year or 4-year conservatory acting program. But then when I came out after residency, that wasn't one of my goals anymore. And that's okay, because when you grow and change, your experiences change you, and sometimes your goals change. So that's why I always say, I go back to that quote, start someplace, go somewhere. I think that one of the other things that women should be really aware of as well is try to be aware of things that are weighing you down. Like, especially for people who are, well, particularly because I'm Asian, so I'm familiar with the Asian culture, but in the Asian culture, there are often a lot of parental restrictions about what you can do and what you can't do. And even if you think those aren't holding you back, there may be some things from your past that are holding you back subconsciously. And it's really important to be aware of any kind of like emotional or psychological baggage that might be holding you down. And try to figure out if there's anything that's holding you back, like if there's any sort of scripts in your head that are holding you back from being successful and being what you think you can be. Like if you think about doing something and then you hear this voice that says, oh, you can't do that, or you hear this voice that says, oh, well, you know, people who do that are so-and-so, or people who do that are, or like, just if you hear voices in your head applying labels to yourself or saying that you can't do things, try to think about where those voices come from and whether or not that's really your voice, or if that's a voice that someone has told you in the past, like a teacher or a parent or something. And if you can identify that as someone else's voice and not your own true voice and goal, then you need to find a way to let that go. Because if you can't let that go, then that's going to keep holding you back.
Thanks for sharing those great tips. And, you know, it's so true, right? You know, sometimes the voices in our heads isn't always ours. And, you know, like you mentioned, growing up as an Asian woman, we get a lot of voices, whether it's from family or society or our culture in general. Like, we have to realize this is just someone's perception. It's not the truth, right? And it's up to you to realize if you want to believe that or not. So thanks for sharing that great tip. And if our listeners wanted to get to know a little bit more about you and what you do, is there any links or social media profiles we can connect with?
For sure. You can connect with me on my website at YvetteLu.com, YvetteLu.com. And I'm also on all the social media sites. So Facebook, Yvette Lu, or Yvette C. Lu. I have two accounts there. Twitter, Yvette Lu, YvetteLu. Instagram, I'm at Yvette Is Here. And definitely people can feel free to contact me on social media if they have any questions.
Thanks for sharing that. And to our listeners, if you want to connect with Yvette, you can also head on over to thetaoofselfconfidence.com and search for Yvette's name. Her show notes will pop up along with everything else we talked about. And I really just want to thank Yvette for taking the time today to share her story and tips with us on self-confidence. So thank you so much, Yvette.
Great. Thank you for having me.
Not a problem. It was great having you on the show. And to our listeners, be on the lookout for another new episode of Another Amazing Woman's Journey to Self-Confidence. And we'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.
Thank you for tuning in to another amazing episode of The Tao of Self-Confidence. Want to learn how you can use podcasting to market your business? Download your free report by visiting our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.